I got this picture printed out years and years ago. It's from where I grew up, and in this video I'm finally going to make a frame for it. I rough pre-cut this cut here on the bandsaw because this piece of wood is only long enough if I fully use both pieces, and this way I can kind of see how it's going to work out. If I hadn't pre-cut that like that, once I cut the molding, I'd have to cut the miters like that, and at that point it wouldn't be long enough for both sides anymore. I'm thinking I should add a bevel to the inside edge here to make it taper in towards the picture, but the other idea is to just take these pieces of wood and bevel them like this, and that just means cutting the bevel on the back. I need to decorate this profile a little bit, and I'll do that by cutting a cove like this on the table saw. Here's the cove cut without any sanding yet. It came out very clean because, as usual, I have a trick up my sleeve. So two things I did is I tilted the blade this way a little bit, so as I'm feeding this way, I'm feeding into the top of the teeth. The other trick is I started with a junk blade and actually rounded the tops of all these teeth by grinding away the alternating points. It looks fairly nice so far, but I want some kind of visible edge on this frame. My thinking is I want some kind of sharp edge here, so I'm thinking I'm going to cut in like this and then a curve like so, and I'll try to approximate that with a table saw. With just a few cuts on the table saw, that already looks like a convex round, but it actually has corners, and I'll try to smooth those over with a hand plane. With a ledge cut for the picture, I'm ready to cut miters into these. And for that purpose, I built myself a miter sled. Well, that looks like it's going to work out. Now I just have to glue it together. I made these picture frame clamping calls many years ago, and by clamping these to the edge of the frame, I can concentrate on getting just one joint at a time lined up perfectly. Now I just got to do that with glue. And the last two joints I have to do at the same time, so I set up on the table saw so I can get at both ends easily. Next it's time to cut some reinforcing splines into here, and for that I'm just going to use a plywood box on my table saw sled. I still need to clean up these splines, and I'll clean those up by cutting a back bevel along the edge using this fence setup. For the glass for this picture frame, I'm going to use this old storm window that I cut from the garbage. Shit! Well, as long as I manage to let this crack not get any longer, I can still use this glass. I got a nice little cavity for a screw head to really hook onto now. I think a bit of a dark bluish tinge will go well with that picture I have for this frame. I'm giving this several coats of water-based Varathane. And that will seal it, give it gloss, and protect the paint I just put on it. I'm just going to put some nails to hold the back plywood in. It feels really manly pushing those nails in with my bare hands, but I did pre-drill the holes. I am quite pleased with how this molding came out, and it was done almost entirely on the table saw. So I ended up drilling two holes in two studs, and I put holes off-center in the picture, so that way I could hang it off the studs and get it exactly where I want it, and it doesn't go back and forth.